The following video presentation is brought to you by the UVM Alumni Association.
2.5 minutes in. 10 on the timer. Carissimo into the lane. Kick out glass. Rises for three. He got it.
And again, that's Sandro Carissimo attacking Brian Duer defensively.
Here, all four for the Seawolves. 5-4 Catamounts. Here's Balch. Free throw line. Jumper rattles in. Pinballed around every part of the iron before dropping through for the junior. Jab step. Enters to the right block for Clancy Rugg. Spin. Shoots from five. Got it.
Nice move by Clancy.
Carissimo just left of the circle. Dribbles back right along the perimeter. Down to the block. Switches to the left and lays it in.
Tremendous move by Carissimo using the high screen and roll.
Thought about a three. Whips it around the arc to Jackson. Out of the left block, Rapier. Back to the basket on glass. Spins baseline. Strong move and he lays it in. Brendan Bald from the near side. Bounces right baseline for Vokel. Back to the basket with 3:40 left in the half. Dumps it middle of the lane. Glass up at the right. Banks it in.
That's three times today. The backdoor cuts on the overplay have worked all night. The Catamounts will take that.
24-17 as Glass catches on the block. Steps back in. Shoots over the shoulder and lays it in. Matt Glass steps to the wing. Back to the far side. Now near wing. Carissimo steps into a three and hits.
Great execution by the Catamounts.
On the near side arc, guarded by Coley. Bounce pass left block. Apfel attacks Joyner. Layup gets it to go with the right hand.
And what Luke did so well right there was catching the ball on the block, jumping into Joyner.
And it's gone in the second half. 31-22 Vermont. Duer steps into a three. High left. All net. This place is rocking. How do the Catamounts handle this? McGlynn dials up a three. He got it.
And that's how you answer it, the rookie of the year draining the three.
Clancy Rugg with a handoff to Brian Vokel. Catamounts with the ball, back to four McGlynn. Step back three, he got it! Back to Sandro, drives on the left baseline, floats from five, taps the front iron, crank of the rebound, back up, cut it, and one!
Second chance opportunities right there for the Catamounts, the big fella.
Sandro on the handle up top, to the far side, Vokel fires to the corner for McGlynn. He wants three, give him three more!
Four answering the call every time.
10 minutes left in the title game. To the mid-post left for Bergman. Kicks back out. Vokel. He tries a three. Got it!
Oh,
wow!
If he's making those, you know that's tremendous.
Still loose and picked up by Coley. Numbers back the other way for Stony Brook. Coley takes it all the way to the rim and finishes and one. Have about a half second differential, if that. Coley. Jab step into the lane, leans in on ball, shoots over him, contested three, front rim, Vokel with a big time rebound in the lane.
And again, it's a two possession game.
Second one on the way, and it rattles around the rim, and drops home! 50-43, Duer steps to a 35-foot three-pointer, that's off the back iron, rebound, batted up top, Carissimo runs, he tracks it down with 17 seconds, he'll pull it out, he's fouled!
Yes, sir.
And they can feel it.
Yes, sir. That the Catamounts were able to hold it on today. This is great as the clock winds down.
5 seconds left. Four McGlynn dribbles out the clock. And the Catamounts are going back to the NCAA Tournament. Dancing time in Vermont. 51-43 the final.
What an unbelievable. There's nothing better than going into somebody else's house and taking their dance tickets.
Cutting down the nets. It'll be the NIT for Stony Brook. Vermont will go to the NCAA Tournament. Smiles and hugs out on the floor.